He who learns but doesn't think is lost. He who thinks but doesn't learn is in great danger. With this, I am Nagendra and welcome you back to my YouTube channel Pro to You Adda. Guys, today we will start revision once again from where we have ended on the previous video. From there only we are going to start. And today we will be discussing about operators and many more. So let's start. With Python operators. In Python, operators are used to perform operations on variables and values. That means if I will be writing a plus b, a is a variable, plus is an operator, and b is again a variable, and a complete processor, a plus b is an operation which should be taking place. Now moving forward, Python divides the operator in the following group: arithmetic operators, assignment operators, comparison operators, logical operators, identity operators, membership operators, and finally bitwise operators. Let's go one by one on deep. Python arithmetic operators. Arithmetic operators are used with numeric values to perform common mathematical operations. Common mathematical operations, how it should be performed? Let's go on deep with an example. Here you may see that x plus y is written. Here x is a variable and y is also a variable, and plus is an operator, and the proper function x plus y, a complete procedure, is known as operation. The same with minus, same with multiplication also. Like x multiply y is written, x is an operator, y is an operator, and operator is what? A multiplication sign, and the complete process is known as operation. Let's go with the next. So our next is Python assignment operators. Assignment operators are used to assign values to variables. How it should assign? Let's go with an example once again. Here written x is equal to 5 means we are assigning 5 to whom? To x. What is a variable? X is a variable here. In second, you may see written x plus is equal to 3. Means here we are assigning x plus 3 to whom? To x. Line number 3, x minus 3 to whom? To x. So this may contains to whole to all of them. Like this, we are assigning the value to a variables. So our next is a Python comparison operators. Comparison operators are used to compare two values. Let's go again with an example. You may see here x is equal to y. We are checking the equality there. X not equal to y, where we are checking not equality. Then greater than, lesser than, greater than is equal to, lesser than is equal to. This all seems that we are comparing the value. Whether greater than, whether lesser than, greater than is equal to, lesser than is equal to, equal to, and not equal to. This all will termed as a comparison operator. Let's go with the next, that is logical operators. Logical operators are used to combine conditional statements. How? Let's see with an example. Here you may see written x lesser than 5 and x lesser than 10. Two conditions are there, and we are checking with an AND operator. It will return true if both statement is true, and if it goes with an OR operator, then if any one of the condition is true, we will be getting true as in return, and in NOT we will get false when if the result is true. Means vice versa condition will be happening with a NOT condition. You may see here written x is lesser than 5 and x is lesser than 10. You know that if the condition remain true, then also you will be getting false as a result. Now next is our Python identity operators. Identity operators are used to compare the objects not if they are equal, but if they are actually the same object with the same memory location. How? Is and is not, two operators we are using here, and it returns true if both variables are the same object. It is the condition with s, and in is not it returns true if both variables are not the same object. Means vice versa will happen with is not. Next is our Python membership operators. Membership operators are used to test if a sequence is presented in an object. How we can go with an example here. You will be watching that two operators are used, in and not in. In will check whether the element is available in Y or not, and not in will check whether the element is not available in element or not. How means in return true if the sequence with the specified value is present in the object, and not in returns true when the sequence with the specified value is not present in the object. Let's proceed with the next topic, that is Python bitwise operators. Bitwise operators are used to compare numbers. Here we are having AND operator, and it is used to set each bit to 1. If both bits are 1, then OR sets each bit to 1 if one of two bits is 1. Then XOR, each bit to 1 if only one of two bits is 1. NOT set inverts all the bits, and 0 fill left shift lift by pushing zeros in from the right and let the leftmost bits fall off. Then signed right shift right by pushing copies of the leftmost bit in from the left and let the rightmost bits fall off. Then our next topic is list in Python. In Python list, we have four major categories. First one is list. It's a collection which is ordered and changeable. It allows duplicate members. Second one is tuple. Tuple is a collection which is ordered and unchangeable, and it allows duplicate members. Then the third one is set. Set is a collection which is unordered and unindexed. No duplicate members allowed here. The fourth one is dictionary. Dictionary is a collection which is unordered, changeable and indexed. No duplicate members are allowed here also. Then our next topic is Python arrays. Now then the question comes, what is an array? Then an array is a special variable which can hold more than one value at a time. If you have a list of items, a list of car names, for example, storing the cars in single variable could look like this. Here you may see how it has been organized. Here the first car name, the second car name and the third car name. Ford is in car 1, Volvo is in car 2, BMW is in car 3. However, what if you want to loop through the cars and find a specific one? And what if you had not 3 cars but 300? The solution is an array. An array can hold many values under a single name, and you can access the values by referring to an index number. Our next is Python classes and objects. Let's see what is a class. Python is an object-oriented programming language. Almost everything in Python is an object with its properties and methods. And a class is like an object constructor or a blueprint for creating a class. Let's see how to create a class. To create a class, use the keyword class. Example, create a class named MyClass with a property named X. Class is here, that is a keyword, and MyClass is a class which contains X, is a variable which contains Y. Now creating an object. Now we can use the class named MyClass to create an object. Let's see with an example. Create an object name P1 and print the value of X. Here P1 is an object which contains MyClass function. We are going to print P1.x. Now assume what will be your output. Yeah, the output is 5. 5 will be the output. Then Our next topic is Python inheritance. Inheritance, which allows to define a class that inherits all the methods and properties from another class. Parent class is the class being inherited from, also called base class. Now let's see what is a child class. Child class is the class that inherits from another class, also called derived class. Now let's see how to create parent class. A parent class is a class. Any class can be a parent class, so the syntax is the same as creating any other class. Let's see with an example. Create a class named person with first name and last name properties and a print name method. Here you can see class is a keyword and a person is a class. Here fname and lname is being used. Fname for the first name and lname for the last name. And printName function is being used. Here we are going to print self.firstname, self.lastname. We are using person class to create an object. Here x we have created as an object is equal to person and we have passed John Doe. And finally we have written x.printName. Here x is an object and being accessed with print name function. Now guys, guess what will be the output. Yeah, the output will be a John Doe, which we have already been passed, and that will be our output. Now let's know how to create a child class. To create a class that inherits the functionality from another class, send the parent class as a parameter when creating the child class. Here we will understand the concept of child class with an example. You can see here we are going to create a class named student, which will inherit the properties as well as the method from the person class. We will use password here. With the password, how the thing will be going on? Class. Next line you will be watching that class student person. And the word pass is being used. Why we have used pass? See, pass keyword we use when we do not want to add any other properties or methods of the class. Let's go in deep. The student class has the same properties and methods as the person class. Example, use the student class to create an object and then execute the printName method. Here you can see x is written, it's equal to student. X is an object and student is a class. We have passed Mike Olson. Then we have recalled x.printName, means we are accessing printName with an object x. Now guess what will be the output. Yeah, obviously the value which we have passed, Mike Olson. So student, that's it for today. We will meet again on next of the lecture. So do subscribe, do like and do share this video, and to be connected and to be notified, press the notification button too. So here, bye bye, Jai Hind.